In this video, let's talk about maxima, minima in much more detail. Now, some students think that always there will be cases wherein you would get maxima also, minima also. But it is not like that. There may be four cases which may arrive. The first case may be that yes, you get a maximum value but do not get a minimum value. That is evident from the previous video that we studied. There was maxima but not minima in the first graph or the first curve that we studied. The second would be that there would be a minimum value but no maximum value for that interval. Even that is clear from the previous video wherein we had a minima but not maxima. The second curve I am talking about. So these two points are firstly written. It says that for a function f defined over an interval I, it may attain only maximum. Only maximum is possible and no minimum value. That means it may attain only minimum value, even that is possible. Now in some cases both maxima and minima may exist, which is what is written. It may attain both maxima and minima. So both maxima and minima, some examples would be trigonometric functions. Suppose I am taking the graph of y is equal to sin x. This is the graph. And now the sin x curve is something like this that you already know. It alternately goes up and down, right? Now, suppose I have to take only the interval 0 to 2 pi into consideration. So the graph would be like this. At 0, it is 0 only. Sin pi by 2 is 1. Sin pi is again 0. Sin 3 pi by 2 is minus 1. And sin 2 pi is again 0. A very roughly made graph only for understanding. Now, you see that what is sin pi by 2? It is 1. It is gaining the highest value. Sin x is attaining the highest value 1 in the interval 0 to 2 pi at pi by 2. So I say that maxima is there and the maxima is at x is equal to pi by 2 and it is what? And it is 1. And maximum value is 1, right? We are talking only about 0 to 2 pi, mind it. Where I is the interval, here 0 to 2 pi is the interval. Let's talk about now minima. Does minima also exist? Yes, when we move forward, we see that at 3 pi by 2, the value corresponds to minus 1. And minus 1 is the least value into consideration in 0 to 2 pi. So I say that minima is at x is equal to minus 1. And what is the minimum value? Sorry, minima is at x is equal to 3 pi by 2. And what is the minimum value? It is nothing but minus 1. So you see that both maxima and minima exist. So 3 pi by 2 and it is equal to minus 1. So sin x or similarly cos x is such kind of a graph, one example of such kind of a graph which has both maxima and minima. Next, sometimes it may also happen that the graph may not attain both maxima and minima. Means it may not have maxima, it may not have minima. What kind of a graph are like these? So some graphs of these are into picture when we study the later videos. But one such example can be taken as y is equal to x cube. See, this is x cube graph. X cube is such kind of a curve which goes somewhere like this. Again, a very roughly made curve. Now you see that what kind of a maximum value or minimum value can we expect out of this? We definitely know that x cube, when we take the derivative, becomes 3x square, and later on in the first derivative test, second derivative test, we know as to why this does not have a maxima or minima. Please mind it. Some people may feel that, okay, this is the maximum value at x is equal to 2. This is the minimum value at x is equal to minus 2. But it is not like that. We are going to see why and how. Minus 2 to 2 definitely is the interval. So there are four cases when we talk about maxima, minima in detail. They may have maxima, they may have only minima, they may have both, or they may not have both. So for details, let's move to the next videos wherein we'll also find the answer to this question as to y is equal to x cube is y not having maxima and minima.